People think of Operation Smile as a cleft organization. We take care of kids with clefts. I think one can also think of Operation Smile as an organization that achieves very high surgical quality. About 1 in 600 children is affected by a cleft. And as we've followed these children back to their villages, as we've gotten to know their family members, and we've identified a whole lot of other suffering, many of it due to surgical conditions, it's really hard to stand by and sort of say, look, we'll treat patients with clefts, but there's nothing else we can do for anybody else. That was really the origin of the project. There's a bush plane that comes in once a day in the morning to these towns, but otherwise they're completely isolated. So they need to be able to really do everything. They're not only the emergency hospital, but they're really the only hospital for most of these people.
Nuestra problemática con el agua no es solo que es insalubre y que realmente no es potable, sino que también a veces no hay. Lavado de manos quirúrgico no hay, sinceramente no hay. No, lo único que hacemos es lavarnos las manos con alcohol, betadine, nos secamos y después nos enguantamos.
Este es el taladro que yo ocupo para hacer este osteosíntesis. Es un taladro con batería recargable. Esto fue comprado en una ferretería.
Esta cirugía se pospuso al menos en dos ocasiones. En muchas ocasiones es frustrante. Es frustrante para nosotros, es frustrante para los familiares.
Es también, operamos a ese paciente, pero llevamos el mensaje y la educación de cómo tratar a tiempo esa cirugía, esa patología. Creo que en realidad sí es un gran proyecto.